Namaste. Hey everybody. We have had quite a day of travel today. We're now in Kuala Lumpur and we started this morning in Ho Chi Minh City. We were getting ready to leave for the airport in Ho Chi Minh City. We got an email alert from AirAsia saying our flight time had been changed by like 45 minutes, but then when we got to the airport, the flight was delayed even longer and they kept changing the gate back and forth, so there was a lot of running around. But then we got to Kuala Lumpur Airport. There was a huge queue at the customs and immigration, so it took us about an hour to get through the airport, and then it's another like 40 minutes into town and to back home. The hostel we're at, which is where we stay when we're in Kuala Lumpur, it's really nice here. They have couples dorms, so Jay and I have a double bed, and it's really nice to be back in Kuala Lumpur. It means Indian food for dinner tonight. There's a huge Tamil community here in Kuala Lumpur, so I am going to give you a short, quick adventure yoga weekly tune-up today. It's not going to be the 45 minutes to an hour that I've been doing because there's a time change, it's late, we need some dinner, and we're just going to do some work that's going to help if you have spent the day in the office, sitting at a desk, curled up in front of the TV. Just a few poses help stretch it out. So let's get started. Sit up tall. Place your hands on your thighs. Thank yourself for coming to your mat today, and thank you for coming to your mat today. It's nice to practice yoga with you. Sit up tall. Stretch long through your spine. Push down through your pelvis. Close your eyes. Take a few deep, long inhales. Adjust your glasses. Take a few deep, long exhales as well. Just long, full breaths. If you can breathe through your nose today, breathe through your nose. Relax your forehead to help relax your mind. Relax your eyes. Relax your neck, butt, sit up tall. Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodha. Yoga is a calming of the fluctuations of the mind. When you've had an active day, those fluctuations are bigger. There's a little more chaos in your mind. It's like rush hour. Take some time to slow your breath down, to slow your mind down. To Anjali Mudra, touch your thumbnails to your breastbone and spread your fingers from there. Let's sing one Om together. Exhale fully. Inhale. Heart and bow your chin. Lower your hands, your chin. Open your eyes. Come into child's balasana. Bring your knees wide, feet flat, touch your big toes together. Sit on your heels, stretch your arms out. Rest your forehead on the ground. Stretch from your shoulders, through your arms, through your fingers. Push with your hands. You can stretch through your spine and push your hips back behind you more. Push your toes down, spread your toes, spread your fingers. Turn the insides of your elbows up some. Steady your breath. Slide your hands back, sit up, bring your knees together, sit on your heels, Bhadrasana. I'm going to turn sideways so you can see. behind your back, interlace your fingers, Paschima Baddha-Guliyasana, shrug your shoulders, bend your elbows, and then as you straighten your arms, point your elbows back behind you. That'll help externally rotate your arms, open up the front of your chest. Move your shoulders down your back, and then lift your hands away from your lower back. Move the front of your ribs back, sit up tall. Draw your belly in, stretch out through the top of your head. If you can bring the heels of your hands together, bring the heels of your hands together. Steady your breath. Slow your mind down. Slow those fluctuations down. Release your hands. Separate your feet about hip distance apart, slightly wider. Sit between your heels, sit on the ground in Virasana. If you can't sit on the ground, you can grab a book to sit on. I don't think Mr. Iyengar would mind you using Light On Yoga as a yoga prop, so you can do that. Or you can just sit on your heels a little bit longer. We're going to do the same Paschima Baddha-Guliyasana here. We're going to change the clasp, so this is the other way. So often we choose one way to interlace our fingers. Mine is always right finger underneath left finger. So this time do the opposite. Do, for me, right finger on top. Bend your elbows. Point your elbows back as you straighten your arms to externally rotate your upper arms. Draw your lower back in. Draw your belly in. Move your ribs back. Sit up tall. Lift your hands. Push down for your toes and hug your outer ankles in. Steady your breath. Calm your mind. Lift your hands a little higher. Release your hands. Lift your butt. Now, I'm going to turn again. Lift your hips up. Bring your left knee into the middle of your mat. Take your right knee back, and then bring your right knee in behind your left knee. Setting up for Gomukhasana. Take your feet wide, lock your hands back, and sit between your feet. Work to stack your knees one on top of the other, and sit up tall. Take your right arm out to the side, stretch your right arm up, bend your elbow, grab your right elbow with your left hand and draw it in more towards your midline, push down with your hand, push your head back into your palm. Take your left arm out to the side, turn your palm back, reach back, bend your elbow, interlace your fingers behind your back or grab your fingers. If that's not possible, just hold your shirt, draw your elbows towards each other and sit up tall. There's gotta be a way that I can see your comments clearly. I can see that people are commenting, so I'm gonna say, hi, how's it going? It's really warm in Kuala Lumpur, but it's really nice to be here. I really enjoy spending a little bit of time in this city, and because the airport's such a big hub, I come through here fairly regularly. Release your arms. Walk your hands forward. Hips up, uncross your knees, then place your right knee in the middle of your mat, take your left knee back behind you, separate your feet enough that when you walk back and sit down, you can sit on the ground between your feet. Stretch your left arm up, bend your left elbow, grab your left elbow with your hand and pull it into the middle of your body, push down with your hand, push your head back into your arm. Take your right arm out to the side, turn your palm back, launch out for the wall, reach back, bend your elbow, grab your fingers or hold your shirt. Put your elbows towards each other. Push down through your pelvis. Draw your belly in slightly and sit up tall. Gomukhasana, side two. Citta Vritti Nirodha. Calm the fluctuations of your mind. Release your arms, walk your hands. forward, uncross your legs, stretch your legs out in front, bend your knees, pull your butt back, grab the outer edges of your feet, stretch long through your spine, and then fold over your legs. Modified Paschimottanasana. You can stay here, or if you want to take it a little further, you can walk your feet a little bit further away. Some of you might be able to go all the way to legs straight, folding over your legs. Move your shoulders away from your ears, hug your elbows in. Stretch through your spine by pulling on your legs, stick your butt back a little more, and stretch the top of your head towards your feet. Steady your breath. Push your heels down and push the backs of your knees towards the ground. And it won't move, but make it a dream, a goal, or a mental image to stick your butt back more, and it'll help you stretch your spine longer. I'll turn sideways so you can see what happens when I do that. So pull on your legs, lift your head and chest, sit up. Place your hands beside your hips so you can watch this. From here, long. Doesn't matter if you get your heels down to the ground or your legs straight or not. I'll do it with knees bent because that's a good place to be. But if you push down through your heels and stick your butt back more, watch what happens to my spine when I do that action, the image of moving my butt back. It helps me get a little more length in my spine. So I can fold over my legs more. Legs straight, it works as well. Imagine that you're moving your butt back to help stretch your spine longer. You can do that again. Grab your feet with your knees bent. Stretch your spine. If you want to straighten your legs more, all the way, you can go for that. No bonus points for legs straight here though. Now push down through your heels and then imagine that you can lengthen your legs back and move your butt back more while you're pulling on your feet. And that's going to help you get more length in your spine. Pull on your feet, lift your head and chest, sit up. Lean back onto your hands, lift your feet, take your right leg underneath your left, cross your left leg over top, sit up, Ardha Mottanasana. Move your hips a little to the right so you can get your left butt cheek down to the ground a little more. Stretch your arms up, twist to the left. It'll look like I'm doing right, but that's just Facebook Live. Hook your right arm outside your left leg. To help with that, hug your left leg in, hook outside your leg, touch your left hand to the ground, sit up tall, and twist. Oh, feels so good after sitting on a plane, sitting on the train, waiting at the airport. Stretch your arms up, come back to center, touch your fingertips to the ground, lean back, and then turn over your legs. Change sides. Move your hips a little bit to the left and work to get your right left cheek down to the ground or closer to the ground. Stretch your arms up, hug your right knee in, twist to the right, your left arm outside your right leg, touch your right hand to the ground. Sit up tall. Lengthen through your spine before you deepen the twist more, and then twist. Oh, feels so good. Arms up, come back to center, bring your hands down back behind you, lean back, stretch your legs out. That's our Ardha Mottanasana for today. Lie down for Supta Padangustasana. Hand to big toe. Straighten your legs, stretch your legs, arms straight. I like the variation that Mr. Iyengar teaches. Place your left hand on your left leg, bend your right knee, draw it in towards your chest, grab your big toe. Wrap your thumb around your big toe, turn your right heel out, and then turn the sole of your right foot up to the sky. keep pointing your left knee up to the sky. It's going to want to turn out. So keep doing a little bit of internal rotation in your left leg. Your left hand is here to help remind you to keep your left leg straight. Pull on your foot, straighten your right leg. Cool. Jane just giving me the time, which means it's time for us to go to dinner, but we're doing our last two poses here. Spread your toes. If you get your right leg straight, look over your left shoulder and start to take your right leg out to the right. Don't roll onto your right hip, though. Uh-oh, wall's in the way. Oh, that's a deeper opening. For it to keep your left leg straight and on the ground. Oh, I'm going to use the wall here for support. That feels amazing. Keep pushing down with your left hand to keep your left side heavy. Your left side even more as you bring your right leg up. Keep it straight, strong, go with it. Bring your right hand to the ground, left hand to the ground, draw your belly in, and slowly lower your right leg down. Place your right hand on your right thigh. Bend your left knee in towards your chest, grab your big toe with your left first two fingers, wrap your thumb around, turn your heel out, turn the sole of your foot up towards the sky. Keep turning your right leg in slightly so your knee points towards the ceiling. And then straighten your left leg as best as you can. Straight or as best as you can. Look over your right shoulder. And if you have your legs straight, then work to open your left leg out to the side. Open the pose. Supta Padavistasana. Keep your right side heavy so you're not rolling over onto your left hip and coming off your right hip. Going to stay here because after all that sitting, walking through the airport, everything's a little tight. This feels incredible though. Breathe. Make your right side even heavier. Lean a little to your right. Lift your left leg up to the ceiling. Keep it lifted. Straight. Bring your hands to the ground. Slowly lower your left leg down. One more pose before a shavasana. Bend your knees. Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. Nice stretch for the front of your torso. Bring your heels near your hips. Make your feet hip distance apart. Push down through your feet, shoulders, lift your pelvis. Imagine that you've got a yoga block between your thighs. Squeeze the block. Push down through your shoulders, lift your breastbone up. Interlace your fingers underneath you. We're only going to do one of these, so choose a way to interlace your fingers, natural way or awkward way. I've chosen awkward way. Push down through your upper arms, push down through your feet, and pull back with your feet to lift your pelvis up. Keep hugging that invisible yoga block between your thighs. If you've got one, you can use it. Stretch the front of your body. Release your hands, lower your pelvis. Stretch your legs straight out, Supta Tadasana. Flex your feet, stretch your arms at your sides. Separate your feet as wide as your mat. Using one or wider than your hips. Relax your feet, relax your legs so they turn out. Move your arms away from your upper body slightly, turn your palms up, tuck your shoulders in a little, close your eyes, and over the next few breaths, release your breath. Work to return to what we call in Sanskrit sahaja. Natural breathing. Shavasana. Rest with yourself. your breath. Take a couple of long, deep inhales and full, extended exhales. Move your fingers, move your toes, move your ankles and wrists. You're doing circles. Go both directions. Stretch your arms up overhead and along the ground. Stretch your toes and legs. Bend your knees. Move your hips to the left a little and roll to your right. Use your left hand for support. Using your left hand, right arm, and the muscles of your upper body, press yourself up to seated. Come to a seated position with your legs crossed. Bring your hands to Anjali Mudra with your thumbnails touching your breastbone. Spread your fingers from there. Sit up tall. Let's end as we began with one Om. Exhale fully. Inhale. Thanks for practicing. Namaste. Thanks, everybody. That's today's short wake up, warm up. Next week, we'll be in Lombok. It's the island in Indonesia. It's the biggest island south of Bali. There are a couple little ones in between. We're going to be spending a couple weeks on Lombok. So we'll do our adventure yoga weekly tune-up from there, either from the beach or from the yoga shala where we'll be spending some time. If your day is just beginning, have an amazing day. If your day is ending like ours is, and you're about to eat dinner like we are, enjoy your meal, enjoy your television, enjoy your friends, your family. Have a great day, have a great night. See you soon. Namaste.